Well, in terms of the periodic table, if this place didn't exist and people didn't come here to work, whole areas of the periodic table wouldn't be there now, and it wouldn't be the periodic table that we know today. So, it's 3:15, and we're about to get in the car to go to the airport. Sunny weather in Stockholm. I don't know what to think about this. I'm getting the feeling that our car may be covered in snow. It may take a while to find our car.
Keep left, then take the exit left.
That is awesome.
Take the exit left.
So, we have reached our destination. Hi, do you speak English?
Yes, we just continue this road.
Uh-huh.
It's not much to see, I'm sorry.
Oh, well, you know.
I think it's after number 65, perhaps.
Okay.
Something like that.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So, somewhere near number 65.
And then you basically take Gruvwagen. No, sorry, it's called Feldspatswagen.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, mate.
Get that out.
Close now. And all the locals know of it, so it must be big. It must be famous. Ah.
Pull up there, pull over there.
Ah. Ytterby Gruva. So. Okay, so it's the birthplace of four elements of the periodic table. Yttrium, Ytterbium, Erbium and Terbium. Ytterby Mine, a historic chemical landmark in my best Swedish. So here we see Yttrium, Ytterbium, Terbium, Erbium, all found for the first time from minerals from gadolinite in this quarry. And we were told by a nice gentleman down the road that we can follow the path up through the woods and hopefully be able to see the mine. So let's go and see if we can find it.
Don't fall over.
So, we've reached the top. Where are we?
Look up yonder, to the left.
Oh, wow. We're gonna scramble up there then. So this is excellent for as a chemist for me to come here to see where these elements first came from. It's really quite cool. Here we can see evidence of the mining. Now this mine closed many years ago, but you can see where the miners have drilled using hand drills into these rocks to make holes to put explosives in to break away the minerals. So very early on, late 1700s, a naval officer called Arrhenius visited the quarry, and I think he may have been prospecting for fuel, and he found a black rock which he thought may have been coal. When he picked the rock up, he found that it was far too heavy to be coal. Coal is just simply hydrocarbonaceous or carbonaceous mineral, but this rock was obviously too heavy to be coal, and he thought that there must be something strange about it. He wondered whether it might be a new ore of tungsten which had recently been found. So he passed this material to a colleague or a professor at the nearby Arbo University for analysis. So that's where the chemistry of the rare earths, as they were called, or the lanthanides, started, with the discovery of four new elements from that original black mineral rock. Yeah, so we found the quarry, and it's breathtaking. It's a surprise that we were able to come, because everyone told us it was fenced off and closed. We didn't see any fences. Anyway, somewhere here, there's a sign which is sort of commemorative of this site. So let's see if we can find this historic landmark sign. So we've now come up the side of the quarry into the sunlight to find that the original plaque from the American Society of Minerals is in situ. So here it says, the ASM has designated Ytterby Mine, a historical landmark for the discovery of four periodic elements, yttrium, terbium, erbium, and ytterbium. And that's actually in chronological order. Yttrium was the first one isolated from the black rock, and over a period of the next 40 to 50 years, successive scientists reanalyzed that sample and were able to extract both terbium and erbium initially, leading to the final isolation of ytterbium in its purest form way back in 1950. So a period of 100 years of chemistry summed up in this sign from this one specific quarry in Sweden.